Hey, How to Wrench fans. We want to make a quick little video here. My buddy Kenny just rebuilt the fuel pump for his Motor Gymkhana bike, and I got telling him, I said, hey, I got a really cool little tool I made up in the How to Wrench shop on how to test electrical components without having fear of, you know, shorting things or having any problems like that. So I'm gonna pass the phone to Kenny real quick. Maybe I can show you this a little better. Okay, so first thing we got to do is we got to figure out which pins on the electrical component, a pump in this case, we need. So we went to the OEM service manual and found out that these two larger gauge wires are for the fuel pump. If you're kind of curious, in this connector, these were for the fuel sending unit to tell the gauge of the fuel. So we know that our hot, following our wire diagram, is this yellow with the red tracer, and that our ground was the black with the white tracer. So let's look at the tool. We know this is a 12 volt system. So what I did is I took and just pre-made up the coolest little rig here. I was kind of overcomplicating and put relays and all that, and figure I don't need that just to test a pump or a fan or something really quick. What I really need to do is to controllably and safely put 12 volts to something so that we don't have any problems, especially around fuel. We don't want any sparks.
Yep.
So cool little switch. I like the LED so I could tell whether it's hot or not. Go ahead here and you can see we just got some alligator clips. Pretty simple. And then, like I said already, it's fused, but just to show you here, it'll light up when it's powered up. But what I'll do here is on the other end, oh, I did something else that was really cool too, that was really smart on the tool. If you notice here, out of the ground side, it's got a pigtail, and then it's a simple bullet pigtail here. What I could do is I can very quickly use all of this already done, and then I make different connectors. In this case, I have the small blade style connector, but if you had the fat, or if you had round ones, or if you had Deutsch, whatever you want to do, you can make quick disconnect junctions that are ready, and then it plugs into your whole fused alligator clip assembly. Pretty rad, right? Mm-hmm. So you can see here, I'll go ahead and clip this back in because this is the style we want. And then I'll go ahead here, and on my red with a white tracer, it's really important that you see this, that this is heat shrunk all the way up. The problem a lot of people have on connectors is they're trying to get in here and they're poking around. People accidentally have something powered that creates a problem, or the two tabs have like bent over and made contact, and then that's a problem. No matter what the case is, if you're dealing with electrical, you really gotta have some attention to detail. So I'm gonna go ahead here and get that one on, give it a little wiggle test. Go to the ground side. Little wiggle test again. Make sure our switch is off. Okay, off. Okay, now powered up and boom. And you can see here, we've even, I'll dump some of this back in here. We really want to see our sample. And tell you, we both thought this was going to be horrid.
Mm-hmm.
Because the pump and filter that you replaced was a super hot mess.
Yep.
So the other thing is, we'll turn this off for a second, is that we ran some fuel with some seafoam mixed up in the gas as well. Huge fan of that product, so that shook it up really good. And we're thinking if there's anything else in there, catch it. Now you got to remember, you have a fuel sock, you have a fuel filter, then you have a pump. It was the pump on the inlet or outlet of this fuel pump, you know?
So pickup, filter, pump, and then what they call their high pressure filter, and then out.
And the high pressure is the one we couldn't take apart.
Right. It was either replace it for $350 or nothing.
So I'm really surprised at how I expected this just to be total garbage. I mean, the other ones I've done, last one I made this tool for, just it was a Honda CBR400,
mm-hmm.
This we're going with the GSXR, and it just was garbage coming out of there, but maybe it sat a few more years. I don't know.
Right.
Anyway, my friends, that's how you could do it safe, do it right, not have any problems. Very, very simple, little fun project here. All right, if you haven't done so, make sure and like, share, subscribe. As always, keep wrenching and make it a great day.